We shall call you Pinocchio.
What a day.
All right, guys, so this is Guillermo del Toro's Pinocchio. This is the 72nd adaptation. You know them adaptations, chat. This is Guillermo del Toro's recent film, the 72nd adaptation of the Pinocchio story, chat. There's been many reinterpretations, adaptations. You know, there's been some good ones, but some entertaining ones, chat. You gotta love the original 40s Disney film. That was one I grew up with. I grew up watching, chat. But let's go ahead and look at this. I'll come back with my thoughts. Hope I'm able to formulate words and sentences. You know, it's you never know, chat. It's very hit and miss with me nowadays. And you come back with your thoughts, chat, and we'll have a nice little conversation, if it's possible.
From my many wanderings on this earth.
Yeah. Like Ewan McGregor.
I had so much to say about imperfect fathers and imperfect sons.
Oh, this kid died.
And about loss and love.
Oh.
I've learned that there are old spirits who rarely involve themselves in the human world, but on occasion.
You destroyed my home! Do.
I want to tell you a story. It's a story you may think you know, but you don't. A story.
Ugh! It's fucking hideous.
A wooden boy.
Where am I?
I feel as though you've been here before.
Help me!
Wooden boy with the borrowed soul. Be his son. Fill his days with light. Monkey. We shall call you Pinocchio.
Yeah!
Rob Perlman, of course, Rob Perlman.
Oh, what a day, what a day.
This looks cute. I'm okay, chat, so I'm telling you right now, I mean, I really dig the animation style. It's kind of like that stop-motion claymation thing going on. Looks very cool. Kind of reminded me also of a lot of Laika movies, you know? Like Kubo and the Two Strings, chap. And so listen, even though we're very overly familiar with the Pinocchio story at this point, there's no doubt about that. It really is the animation that is, you know, standing out to me. And kind of makes me excited to see it. I want to check this out. It looks super cute. I mean, they got a hell of a talented voice cast, chap. I mean, Ewan McGregor sounds great as Jiminy Cricket. And anyhow, you got Tilda Swinton. You got it looks like she's playing the fairy, chap. You got Ron Perlman, probably is a villain of some kind. Man, Guillermo del Toro, he's my friend. He loves Ron Perlman. But yeah, I'm really liking this. This looks really cool. But what about you guys? What are your thoughts and feelings on the Pinocchio trailer? Nailed it, chat. I got through that without messing up any words this time. Woohoo! Let's see. There are 31 official film adaptations of Pinocchio. All right, so I was close. I said like 72. So I wasn't too far off. Let's see here, chat. Let's see here. Don't tell me what I gotta love. Oh, Osgood Winston Duke. Oh, yeah. Thankfully, Colonel Tom Hanks is not in this one. Oh, I think it's the same composer Jim Barr. The music's very pretty. But Pinocchio's always painted. He is creepy as fuck. Is just playing what he is. It's horrifying. Although, in that new Disney movie they're making, that looks pretty scary too. So it reminds me of James the Giant. Oh, yeah. Yo, same, yeah, definitely same animation style. I could see that as well. Is Doug Jones in this? Probably. Probably did the mocap. This is super cute hamburger. This looks like a much more unique and interesting adaptation of Pinocchio. A live-action Disney thing. Agreed. Takes place in 30s fascist Italy. Oh, I don't think the cute shit's going to avail us. We're like, oh, damn. Oh, that's cool. Oh, nice. So the setting's going to be in, oh, wow, in fascist-controlled Italy. Nice. I like that.
Father, when can I leave to be on my own? Father, why can't I have human skin?
Swedish girl, it sucks. Swedish girl is not impressed. I know people are hyping up Guillermo del Toro, and he deserves it, absolutely. I think he should also hype up that creator of Over the Garden Wall, Patrick McHale, is the co-screener of this. Oh, that's nice. I gotta watch that show. I've heard very good things. Because also, it looks decent. Geppetto is voiced by the actor from the Game of Thrones who played the head of the family that committed the Red Wedding. Oh, fucking, oh god, yeah, Walder Frey. Oh shit, that actor is amazing. What's that guy's name? He also plays Filch. Damn it, help me out here, chat. Help me out here. You like fascism? No! I'm just saying it's interesting for a setting for a Pinocchio movie. David Bradley. And who was something Bradley? It was like something Bradley. David Bradley. Thank you so much. Also makes people forget. Oh, the Pauly Shore nonsense. Yeah. Yes. Many, many Pinocchio adaptations. I'm thinking, Chad, I think we can at least expect this to be better than the Pauly Shore Pinocchio. I think we can all bet on that. I'll put money on that, Chad. I'll bet on that. But yeah, no, this looks really cute and really wholesome. I'm digging what I'm seeing. Chad, again, the art style is really standing out. But hearing about the setting taking place, which, you know, obviously, yeah, Pinocchio has taken place in Italy before. I think most of the time it takes place in Italy. But to hear that it's, ooh, during the 1930s, fascist control in Italy, that's an interesting setting. You're going to see the black shirts. I'm sure we'll see the black shirts. I'm sure there'll be a Mussolini reference or two. So that'll be interesting. But, my friends, there has been another trailer release, and this is for Sylvester Stallone movie, The Samaritan. If someone can provide me the link for that, we can go ahead and watch that. We can get into some riff tracks, and we can get into some riffing chat. Probably better than the Zemeckis one. Zemeckis did a Pinocchio movie? What Pinocchio movie did he do? I don't even know about that one. Maybe he did. Wait, did he do it? Did he do one? Oh, shit, I don't remember. I don't recall that at all. Too many goddamn adaptations, shit. Oh, Zemeckis is doing the new one. Oh, gotcha. Okay, I see what you're saying. Okay. Yeah, no, that looks, I mean, what I saw from that movie so far, it looks horrifying. Pinocchio just has those dead eyes. He has those cold, dead eyes. This one just looks more unique to me. I bet because these are coming out, the same? When is this coming out? These are probably coming out the same year, right? Maybe. That's going straight to Disney Plus. I know that's coming out later this fall. Netflix. So this is coming out Netflix. Let's see here. And it's like, oh, November. So this is coming out, oh, November and December. Okay, so select theaters in November and then Netflix in December. And so Disney's version is coming out sooner, right? Okay. Oh, boy. Well, I'm more excited for this one. This looks a lot better.